Welcome to Top Crew Aviation. This is Captain P.K. Yadav.
Hello everyone. I'm sure you must be doing good. So today we will discuss about weather deviation. As I told you in my previous video, it is very important topic for RTR exam. We should know each and everything about weather deviation. So guys, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get all upcoming videos. So let's start. As we all know now, we will always deviate because of the weather. So now there are some set of procedures which we all should know before making weather deviation call, guys. Weather deviation procedures come under DOC 4444 PANS ATM. You should know about it. It's an important question for part 2, but don't worry, we will again cover it in part 2 video. Alright guys, over here, let me tell you, DOC is like document. So this is not something which you cannot remember. Keep it in mind, DOC means document. So DOC 4444 means document 4444. PANS stands for Procedures for Air Navigation Services. ATM stands for Air Traffic Management. Don't get confused with our ATM, Visa, MasterCard. In part 2, they may ask you in Viva about so many full forms. It is one of them. So I'll keep covering it as per the topic. Don't worry about that. So whenever, guys, pilot communicates with ATC during weather deviation, pilot will use below phrase. What is that particular phrase? That is weather deviation required. Why do we need to use this? To indicate that priority is desired on the frequency and for ATC response. So these two things which we need, like we need priority and ATC should response us because we are looking for the weather deviation. In case pilot is not getting priority even after using above phrase, guys, what will happen? Pilot should initiate the communications. What he can do? He should initiate the communication using the urgency call, pan pan and message. So in case weather deviation required is not working, you can use pan pan. Do remember, guys, we cannot enter inside the weather in any situation, guys. Okay guys, so the pilot shall inform ATC when a weather deviation has been completed and the aircraft has returned to its cleared route. Means whenever your weather deviation has been completed, guys, it does not mean that you are out of danger and you will keep going. No, keep it in mind, guys, you have to inform because ATC is worried about your situation. He is monitoring. All right, he wants to listen, he wants to get the response from you. What's going on? What you are doing? What is your plan? What next? So once you will inform to the ATC that you are on your particular track, guys, that ATC will chill. All right, now I don't have to worry about this particular aircraft. So keep it in mind, guys, you have to inform to the ATC whenever it is not required. It is also important, guys, to inform that you are back on your desired route because once you are on track, ATC will not bother about it. Now we will, you know, study about actions to be taken when controller pilot communications are established. It means pilot is talking to the ATC. What will happen? Pilot should notify ATC and request clearance to deviate from track, and pilot will tell like where he would be deviating, when he would be deviating and how he would be deviating. These things pilot will notify to the ATC. Now guys, it's ATC turn. Okay, so ATC should take one of the following actions. Number one,
if separation can be applied, he will issue clearance
because no problem, he has enough space to separate the traffic. Number two point, guys, if there is conflicting traffic, means ATC is not able to give you separation because he does not have a space for you. So what will happen in that case? He will tell you his inability, like he is not able to give you the permission, and will also mention like why he is not able to give you that permission and will also ask about your intention. This is what my situation. I am not able to give you the clearance. What will you do or what is your intention? Alright guys, so the pilot should take the following actions. What he can take: comply with the ATC clearance, advise your intentions to ATC, and execute the procedures. So this is how things work. In case if you are not getting anything, you need not to worry. You can comment me, you can WhatsApp me. I will try to respond as soon as possible. Okay, so let's go ahead guys. Actions to be taken if a revised ATC clearance cannot be obtained. If the aircraft is required to deviate from track and prior clearance cannot be obtained, what we need to do? First of all, try to contact an ATC, get the clearance as soon as possible. Until an ATC clearance is received, pilot shall take the following actions. What are the actions? Deviate away from route, contact nearby traffic on 1:1.5 at suitable interval and give your aircraft identification, flight level, position with time, route, and declare your intentions, guys.
These are the actions which you need to take being a pilot
while you do not have ATC clearance. And there are some other things which we, you know, also need to take care. Watch for conflicting traffic, both visually and by reference to ACAS, guys. If equipped, turn on all aircraft exterior lights. For deviation less than 10 nautical mile, guys, do remember, if any deviation, it is not only about weather deviation, in RVSM as well, in terms of other thing as well, whenever we deviate from the route, if our deviation is less than 10 nautical mile, we will never change level. Wherever we were flying, let's say we were flying at flight level 120, we will continue to fly at flight level 120. But in case your deviation is greater than 10 nautical mile, then you have to initiate a level change. That would be plus minus 300 as per your track. So guys, if your track is between 000 to 179, it means you are easterly. If you take right turn, you have to climb. If you take left turn, you have to descend. So plus minus 300, opposite and westerly direction. I'm sure you must be clear.
This table is self-explanatory, guys.
Still, if you have issues, let me know. See guys, if contact was not established prior to deviating, continue to attempt to contact ATC to obtain clearance. If you don't have any contact, keep trying. If contact was established, guys, in case you are able to contact with ATC,
continue to keep ATC advised of intentions and obtain essential traffic information, guys. This is how we would be dealing
when we do not have ATC clearance. So guys, this is how things work in real life, which we should know before making calls for weather deviation. I will cover in next video. So next video would be on like how to make weather deviation call for RT exam. So guys, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get that. You can comment and WhatsApp me in case of any query. Also tell me what is tough for you. Don't worry if it is tough for you. I will make it easy for you in my future videos. Alright guys, take care. See you soon.
Here you go. Your checklist. Like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching.